As we talk to parents, we're able to help them see that school could be something different. It could be
MIT grad Kelly Smith got the idea to invent a new kind of micro school. So he did. It's called Prenda, and its growth in Arizona has been explosive.
I talked to my friends who had children and trusted me, and they pulled their kids out of school and sent them to my house every day, and we created a micro school, 7 children at the time. One of them was mine.
The first thing to know about Prenda is its growth trajectory. From that first group of just 7 kids, on a semester-by-semester basis, enrollment went to 20, then 30, then over 500. By the start of next year, they're expecting 1,000. The next thing to know is their rather untraditional school facilities.
We are in my house, right here.
And also,
we are at my children's school. Not just my children, 8 additional children in addition to my 2 girls.
It's kind of a hybrid between homeschool and traditional school. You get the socialization, you get the curriculum, like a traditional school, but you get the homeschool feel.
Each Prenda school has only 5 to 10 students. And to some who work there, it represents the education version of a larger techno-cultural trend.
Think about Uber and the fact that it allows a normal person to own a taxi. And you think about Airbnb and the way it allows a normal person to own a hotel. Prenda allows a normal person to run a school.
My son's class previously was like 35 kids to 1 teacher. So it's quite the drastic extremes that way.
I was a regular public school teacher and then I became a guide at Prenda. And I went from having 150 students to having 9, which is incredible. And in the first week, I was able to meet with every student one-on-one to curate and create curriculum that was at their level, which was something I've never been able to do in my teaching career.
Like a Montessori model, Prenda schools combine kids of different grade levels, but only within a 3-year range, either K to 2nd grade, 3rd to 5th, or 6th through 8th grade. The different ages not only make the kids less competitive and more open to mentoring each other, it also makes self-paced learning feel more natural.
The public school that I went to last year, I didn't really like it because I couldn't work at my own pace, and I was kind of falling behind a tiny bit. I didn't feel like I fit in.
And he would come home and say, "Mom, I'm so bored." He would say, "We've talked about this thing for days and days and days, and I got it in the first 5 minutes that they talked about it."
But beyond the personalized pacing is the personalized encouragement offered to all students regardless of their ability.
Oh, I love that picture.
Our oldest son did public school for the first 5 years, you know, of his schooling, and he was always kind of struggling. As he got up each grade, he wasn't progressing intellectually at the same level. And that caused a significant amount of stress for him.
The traditional public school for kindergarten for the one daughter was not working. I don't know, it was kind of like she would just zone out in the classroom setting.
In public school, when they label these children start to have like low self-esteem. They think they are failures, they can't do anything.
And so, to the Prenda parents, this encouragement factor is enormous. And they ask why, in traditional public schools, must so many students be reminded over and over again that they're not as smart or as popular as someone else.
And it totally affects your self-esteem, your self-confidence, and the way you see your place in the world and what you can accomplish. You know, you start to feel like you can't do it.
Then she went to Prenda. And it was a night and day difference in her. In her happiness, in her excitement about learning.
Students also gravitate to Prenda for something it doesn't have.
We have a terrible problem right now, and it's rampant throughout the country. Bullying, it's a terrible problem. A mom called me today. She has 3 kids. Her first grade daughter, I mean, we've only been in school here a few weeks, first grader is being teased terribly every day and is coming home crying.
My oldest was in traditional public school, and there was always something sketchy happening on the bus.
Prenda is great because everybody around me like just likes me being there and there's no negative vibes.
Prenda heavily involves students in the design of their own education, not just with projects or reports, but even in the compulsory subjects where they set their own progress goals. The concept is that maximizing each student's feeling of agency or control produces more buy-in.
In a regular school setting, when things are pushed down their throats, that's just going to get resistance. But when you say, look at these things you can learn about, what do you want to learn about first, they're more inclined to take ownership of their own learning.
I think it's really important to understand the difference between coercion and persuasion. And persuasion is still a big factor. And so we have to persuade the kids to work hard.
At every grade level, the Prenda school day is broken up into three parts. The first is Conquer, where students use online tools to learn traditional subjects like math, science, reading, and writing.
We have the certain time, so first time is Conquer, and that's when we do all of our goals. So like I said, math and all that stuff.
Collaborate is where kids work together to do projects. Here, a middle school-aged girl selected the country of Guatemala for the class focus, and then other students picked subtopics within that for their own reports, like the Guatemalan economy, politics, and media. And Create, where students make something that interests them. Here, K through second grade kids are imagining and building new kinds of safety equipment, much of it out of cardboard and tape. But then the young inventors are explaining their designs to the group and learning to field questions.
This I made from the box from a pancake maker, a pancake box.
When you look into how much money a school is bringing in, you wonder, where is all this money going to?
Prenda isn't a homeschool in the usual sense. Prenda schools can be run in all kinds of facilities, and the guides are paid. The funding coming through either Arizona's ESA School Choice Program or through student enrollment in an online charter school. But without the usual expensive buildings and administrative staffs, Prenda's annual cost per student is only $5,500. And it begs the question, while these happy parents and educated kids are costing taxpayers less, are they nevertheless siphoning funding away from traditional public schools?
So I had to come from this place of, do I feel guilty that I'm not sending my kids to the public school? I totally felt that for a while. But then I realized, this is what's great for my family, and what's great for my family is great for the community. And what's great for the community is great for my state, and my country, and my world.
We're still paying our taxes, it's going to it. There is money going away, but it's also, it's per child, and so that money needs to be going to the best education option for that child.
People who feel that way, I have misconceptions about what these programs do, or they have an allegiance to just a government type of education program, and it becomes more of a political thing than it is about the education, or maybe they have some kind of, you know, bias to it because it personally affects them. Maybe they are employed by the public school system.
Especially surprising is that amid these comparisons to traditional public schools, one of the new Prenda schools is being run by a traditional public school.
So I am a principal of a traditional public school, K through 6 elementary school. Kind of when you think of a stereotypical elementary school, that's what I represent. But more importantly than that, I'm someone who works in education because I care about kids learning and being successful and finding a way to be happy each day. We are piloting an experience here on our campus with the Prenda model, and what it looks like is we got a special opportunity from our district to authorize a micro school to be housed here on campus. There are some kids that just do a lot better with a very different experience from the one that I'm used to calling school.
Prenda hopes to expand beyond Arizona soon, but for now these parents say their kids aren't just learning more, they're loving school, advancing at their own academic paces instead of a large classroom's pace, and getting individual socio-emotional needs met in a small group setting, all for a fraction of what's being spent by today's traditional public schools.
I'm able to ask them at the end of the day what they've learned or what they did that day, and they can tell me in detail what they did all day long. Whereas before, I would pick them up from school and say, what'd you guys do today? I don't know, nothing.
To see the huge spike in demand for a small, intimate experience that's still getting great results for students says volumes about the culture and the academic results that Prenda is getting. Parents are choosing them at high numbers, and given the choice marketplace that they have access to, this says that they have figured out that secret sauce for students.